In today's video, we're going to be talking about whether or not insulin resistance causes obesity, or if it is the other way around and obesity actually causes insulin resistance. Insulin resistance is extremely common, with an estimated 88% of American adults suffering from it. Unfortunately, it is not routinely diagnosed, but signs of insulin resistance include excess abdominal fat, high blood pressure, and high triglycerides, symptoms that a lot of people suffer from, although they do not realize that insulin resistance is the root of them. By understanding the role that insulin resistance plays in obesity, we can better understand how to combat it and reach a healthy body weight. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about the connection between insulin resistance and obesity. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform that does it all. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. We're going to start off today talking about what insulin resistance is and what causes it, and then we will get into how it is linked to obesity and how understanding this connection can help us to lose weight. Insulin resistance. Insulin resistance is when the cells in our body resist the actions of insulin, and our insulin levels remain elevated for prolonged periods of time. This in turn leads to a wide range of symptoms and diseases, including obesity, but also type 2 diabetes, heart disease, and PCOS. Insulin is a hormone in our body that is responsible for signaling our cells to accept glucose, also known as blood sugar. So when our blood sugar goes up, the pancreas releases insulin, which takes the excess glucose from our bloodstream to our cells. This includes our muscle cells, our brain cells, and our liver cells. But if our cells become insulin resistant, they are no longer accepting the correct amount of glucose. So more insulin is pumped out to deal with the blood glucose, which has remained high, and it turns into this vicious cycle where the high insulin is causing insulin resistance, and then the insulin resistance is causing high insulin, and the problem gets progressively worse until it manifests as other diseases. Having high glycemic variability, which is when your blood sugar levels fluctuate a lot throughout the day, is associated with insulin resistance. If your blood sugar is constantly spiking throughout the day, this means that your body is having to pump out a lot of insulin to deal with it. And if your insulin levels don't have a chance to come back down to baseline before your blood sugar spikes again, then your insulin levels are going to remain high. And this is where the cycle starts. But how does this tie in with obesity? Insulin resistance and obesity. Now, there is some debate over which comes first, insulin resistance or obesity. And while the two often go hand in hand, it is possible to be insulin resistant without being obese and without even being overweight. And it is also possible to be obese without being insulin resistant. One nickname for insulin is the fat storage hormone. And this is because when insulin levels are high, the body is storing fat and not burning it. And this makes sense because insulin is released when there's excess glucose in our blood, and glucose is energy for our cells. Insulin is the signal that tells our body we have energy readily available, so we do not need to bring energy out of our fat stores. Now, let's think about the situation we spoke about earlier, where an individual's blood sugar is constantly spiking throughout the day. With blood sugar always spiking, insulin is always being pumped out, and the body is constantly in fat storage mode, taking the excess energy and storing it for later use. High glycemic variability, such as this, often is the result of eating high carb and high sugar foods frequently throughout the day. Cereal and orange juice for breakfast, a granola bar as a mid-morning snack, a sandwich for lunch, pasta for dinner. Foods high in carbohydrates are broken down by the body into glucose, and this causes our blood sugar to rise. So frequently eating these foods throughout the day certainly seems like a recipe for insulin resistance and obesity. However, there is evidence that it is actually the inverse that occurs, and obesity actually causes insulin resistance. But it is the type of fat you have that matters. There are two main types of fat, subcutaneous fat and visceral fat. Subcutaneous fat is any fat on your body that you can pinch, and it can be stored just about anywhere. Visceral fat is stored in the abdominal cavity surrounding your organs, and this type of fat is hard. You will not be able to grab it. And it is actually only visceral fat, and not subcutaneous fat, that is associated with insulin resistance. In the book, Why We Get Sick, which is all about insulin resistance, Ben Bickman writes, "When visceral fat from an obese animal is transplanted into a lean animal, the recipient animal becomes insulin resistant immediately. In contrast, when subcutaneous fat is transplanted into a lean animal, it remains insulin sensitive. And this is why someone who is not obese, but has a lot of visceral fat, can be insulin resistant. But how can we apply this knowledge to help us lose weight and combat obesity?" I am going to answer that question in just 1 second, but first I want to take a quick moment to tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. It is thanks to companies like Squarespace that I am able to put out 2 videos per week for you guys and provide you with as much free content as I do. So if you are thinking about building a website for your business or for personal needs, such as a blog, definitely check out Squarespace. I have used a few other similar platforms in the past, and none of them were as intuitive to use, had everything I needed, and really ended up looking as good as Squarespace. Seriously, the templates are awesome and so easy to customize with style editing. One of the coolest things about Squarespace is that they have SEO, or search engine optimization tools, built right in. This means that your website will be found in search results by the right people more often. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial. And when you love it and decide to launch, use code HealthCoachKate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. All right, so how can we use our understanding of insulin resistance to fight obesity and lose weight? The answer is pretty simple, actually. The goal should be to keep insulin low. Because when insulin is kept low, our cells will start to become more sensitive to it again. And we will also be able to burn fat more easily. The 2 main ways you can keep insulin low are to eat foods that have a minimal impact on insulin and to eat less frequently. Foods that have a smaller impact on insulin are those that are high in protein and healthy fat. Think eggs, meat, fish, low sugar fruits such as avocado, and non-starchy vegetables such as broccoli. Focus your diet around these whole foods and the amount of insulin your body is pumping out will remain much lower. And I do have a whole video on the best foods for insulin resistance, which I will link above if you want to know more. And the second part here is to eat less frequently. So this might mean intermittent fasting, where you only eat within a specific time period every day, but it can also mean simply skipping snacks throughout the day. By doing this, you will have less spikes in insulin throughout the day. And I do have another video on the different variations of intermittent fasting and the benefits of it, which you can check out if you want to know more. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below what you thought of the video. Your comments, your likes, and of course your subscriptions really help to support my channel. They help YouTube know that you liked my video and then they push it out to more people. So thank you if you take the time to do any or all of those actions. And remember to check out Squarespace for all of your website and online business needs. I will put the link to start a free trial in the description box down below. And if you guys did like this video, you might also like my video on how to get rid of visceral fat, which you can check out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it right here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.